Hi, welcome to 30 Minute Pilates. I'm Jerry Weatherholtz, Pilates instructor in Sinking Spring, and thank you for joining me again for another episode of 30 Minute Pilates. Tonight we're going to be using a flex band. Many people have one of these at home. If you have one, go ahead and dig it out. If not, you don't need to use one. If you have a long towel, or a man's tie, that will work as well. Or you don't need to use anything at all. But this is just going to add another dimension to our workout. Before we begin, I'd like to encourage home viewers with questions to call 610-378-0426. Okay, let's get going. So we're going to start by sitting down. We're going to take the band, the flex band, or if you have a towel or whatever you have. Bend your knees. Put your feet either flat or feet flexed. Shoulders down. We're just going to get a little bit of resistance work here. Just going to pull the band apart and then release. And again, pull it apart and release. Now you can, the breathing, you can inhale or exhale on the pulling apart and releasing, whatever is more comfortable. The most important thing is that you're breathing. And release, and again, pull it apart and release one final time, and pull it apart and release. Okay, now take the band, place it around the arches of your feet. Sit up tall. If you have tight hamstrings and you're having trouble sitting up tall, you can bend your knees for this as well. Otherwise, keep your legs stretched straight out in front of you. We're going to do a little bit of rowing. So shoulders down, belly button in. Keep your arms tucked close to your sides. Pull back and release. I like to inhale as I pull back and exhale and release. Now, it's very important to keep the wrists straight without any wrinkles, because you don't want to be putting the pressure on your wrists. You want to be working your arms and your abs and your back muscles, and release. Pull back, inhale, exhale, release up nice and tall. Pull your belly button in and release. Let's do four more times. Inhale, pull, exhale, release, and pull two, and release two more. Pull and release one more time, and pull and release. Now you could hold these this a few seconds. You could pull back and hold for three counts. One, two, three, and then slowly release. Let's do two more like that. Inhale, pull back, hold two, two, three, and then release one more time. Inhale, pull back and hold three, two, three, and then release. Okay, now let's start with 100. So I'm going to show you the variations. I typically do the full version, but you can, you know, certainly do a variation. A variation would be to bend your knees, keep your head down. You could put it up on a pillow or a rolled up towel, but I'm going to do the full version. So take your band if you have one. You can fold it in half. I like to do that for more resistance. Put it behind your legs. Now you can either keep your legs stretched straight up to the ceiling or lower them to a 45 degree angle. Either way, squeeze them together. I'm lifting my head, but you certainly don't have to. Pull your shoulder blades down into your back, press your belly button into your spine, and pump your arms. Inhale, one, two, three, four, five. Exhale, two, three, four, five. Inhale, two, three, four, five. Exhale, two, three, four, 20. Inhale, two, three, four, five. Exhale, two, three, four, 30. Inhale, two, three, four, five. Exhale, two, three, four, 40. Inhale, two, three, four, five. Exhale, two, three, four, 50. Inhale, two, three, four, five. Exhale, two, three, four, 60. In two, three, four, five. Exhale, two, three, four, 70. Inhale, two, three, four, 5. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 80. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 90. Inhale, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 100. Take a break. Whew. Okay. Now, if you've got the band, take it in your hands again. Pull it apart slightly so you have a little resistance. For the roll-ups, you can keep your knees bent. A lot of people like to keep their knees bent. That's perfectly fine. I'm going to straighten my legs out in front of me. Squeeze them together, press the belly button into your back, stretch your arms back, keep your ribs down, then inhale, lift your arms, then lift your head, chin to your chest, exhale, over. Now, if you're having trouble doing the roll-ups, on the next one, I will show you a half roll-back that you can do as a substitute, because you don't want to put any pressure on your neck or your back. Now, so for this one, if you're having trouble with a full roll-up, just do the half roll-back. So you'd roll back and roll up. It's very effective as well. But I'm going to continue with the regular roll-ups for three. Peel up, belly button back, exhale, keep your shoulder blades down, and stretch four. Exhale over, roll down, and stretch back. Lift your arms, chin to your chest, lift your head, exhale over, and down, and back. Five more times, lift arms, lift your head, exhale over, and roll down, and back. And you don't have to do 10, you can stop whenever you need to stop. You can stop at 5, 6, any roll-ups that you do are certainly helpful. You don't have to do all 10. Exhale, down, belly button into your back. Exhale, and let's do one more. And down, and back. Okay, now often by the last one, you'll need to adjust yourself on the mat because you'll have started to slide. For some reason, roll-ups do that. Okay, hug your knees into your chest to release your back. Now, take your band again if you have one. Wrap it around the arch of your right foot. Now, your left leg can either be bent, or I'm going to stretch mine out in front of me. I like to stretch it out, but if you feel that you need to bend your knee to keep the back flat, then go ahead and do that. So we're going to wrap that band around the arch. Pull on it enough so you have a little bit of tension. Turn that right leg out if you can. If not, keep it parallel. But if you can turn it out, you're going to get into your inner thigh a little bit more. Now, anchor the shoulders back. Make sure the hips are down. Both hips are down. Your pelvis is still. So circle the leg across your body, around, and pull it up. The breathing is inhale to start, exhale to come up. Three, exhale around and up. Across four, around and up. Across five, around and up. Let's reverse direction. We're going to go out for one, around, across, up. Two, out, around, and up. Three, out, around, and up. And four, out, around, and up. One more, and five, out, around, and up. And then give that leg a stretch. And then switch legs. Now put the band behind your left foot. Extend your right leg out in front of you with a little bit of turnout. Belly button into your back, and circle the leg across, down, around, up one, and across, down, around, up two, across, down, around, up three, across, down, around, up four, and across, down, around, up five. Reverse direction. Out, down, around, up one, out, down, around, up two, out, down, around, up three, out, down, around, up four, and out, down, around, up five, and give that leg a stretch. Okay, now we're going to roll up to a sitting position. Now lift your hips, bring your hips to your heels, and we're going to do an exercise called rolling like a ball. So you can either do it this way, you can tuck in tightly, or you can hold on behind your thighs like this, right at your knees. That seems to be more comfortable for most people. Keep your shoulders down, pull your belly button in, then inhale, rock back, and exhale, roll up. And again, inhale back, and exhale to roll up. Three, and exhale up. Rock back. Four, and exhale to roll up. And five, and roll up. And then put your feet down, lift your hips, sit back on the mat. Now roll back down on the mat. Now for the ab series, you can keep your head down if you need to. You can prop up on a pillow. I'm going to lift my head, but you certainly don't have to. So you put your right hand on your right ankle, your left hand on your right knee. Extend your left leg out, and then change legs. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight, nine, 10. Take a break. If your head is up, you want to put your head down just to rest your neck. Take a little bit of a breather. Now the next one, lift up or keep your head down. Either way is fine. Put your hands on your ankles. Stretch your arms to your ears and your legs out, and then bend your knees and pull them in and grab near your ankles again. Second one, stretch up and bring it in. Stretch up. Three, and bring it in. Two more. Stretch. Four, and bring it in. One more time, and stretch. Five, and bring it in. Rest your head down if you've been keeping it lifted. Otherwise, just keep your head down. Next one, either keep your head down or lift. Again, I'm going to lift. Left leg goes out, right leg goes up, and switch legs. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight, nine, 10. Now, right into putting your hands behind your head, squeeze legs together, pull your belly button into your back, and just lower your legs a little tiny bit, not very much. Second one, and bring it up. 3, and lift. 4, and lift one more time, and 5, and lift. Now rest your head down. Now, let's grab our bands again, if you have one. And I'm going to show you how you can do this exercise with a band. And it's particularly effective for the abdominal area. So you'd wrap the band around both feet, around the arches of your feet. You can either keep your head down, or again, I'm going to lift up, but you don't have to. Look into your belly button, squeeze your legs together. And the resistance of the band, it seems like you have more control. 2 and up. Inhale down, 3. Exhale up. 4, and up. And you can go down a little bit lower with your legs. 5, and up. Okay, take the band, place it aside, hug your knees into your chest. Now for the crisscross, put your hands behind your head. Don't interlace, just layer them one on top of the other. Bend your knees into your chest. If you twist to the right, extend your left leg, bring your left elbow to your right knee, come back to the center, and switch right elbow to your left knee, and then come back. Twist to the right, and then come back to the center. Twist to the left, and then come back one more set. Twist to the right, come back to the center, and twist to the left, and come back and rest and take a break. Now put one foot down, put your hands behind your other knee, lift your head, and roll up to a sitting position for spine stretch forward. Here again, we can use the band for a little bit of added resistance. So you can either keep it single, or you can fold it in half. I like to fold it in half so I get a little bit more resistance. Now, flex your feet. Just open your feet about the distance of your mat or towel, whatever you're using. Not real wide. Shoulders down, belly button in. Pull the band apart for resistance. Stretch forward, head down as if the crown of your head is going to reach the floor. Pull your belly button back and roll up one vertebra at a time. And a second one. Exhale forward. Inhale, stack up. And 3, exhale, stretch forward, and inhale to peel up. 2 more times, exhale, stretch forward, and inhale to peel up. Try to keep both seat bones down. 1 more time, exhale, stretch, and inhale to peel up. Okay, now the next one we're going to do is the saw. I'm going to show you a way you can use this for the saw. You don't have to do this. You don't have to use it. It does make it more challenging. You can put the band behind your back, extend your arms out so you have a little bit of tension, keep your feet flexed. Now let's twist to the left first. As you twist to the left, keep the right seat bone down on the floor and saw off your left toe and then come up and center. Now twist to the right, saw off your right toe and then come back. Twist to the left, saw the toe off, come back to the center, twist to the right. Now as you're sawing off that toe, try to keep the opposite seat bone down because it is going to want to lift. Come right back up to the center, and last time, twist, 2, 3, and then come up, and then you can place your band down. And shake out your legs, you might be a little bit tired after that. Okay, now we're going to the next thing. Before we go on to the sideline series, it's time to take a break. I'd like to remind everybody, if you're enjoying 30-Minute Pilates, please become a member of BCTV. We'll be right back.
You're watching 30-Minute Pilates on BCTV.org. Be informed. Be involved. Be a member. For membership information, go to www.bctv.org/support/membership. For more on exercise and health issues, go to bctv.org. Program underwriting is a valuable source of revenue for bctv.org. For more information on how you and your business can become program underwriters, go to bctv.org.
Hi, welcome back to 30-Minute Pilates. Now, the next exercise that I'd like to show you is one where you're lying on your stomach. Now, please, if for any reason you should not lie on your stomach, please omit this exercise. Do not do this. I'm just going to show you for anyone who is able to lie on their stomach and wants to give it a try. We'll just do a couple of reps. Okay, So, I'll turn over on your stomach. Make your hands into fists. Prop up on your elbows. See how my elbows are a little bit wider than my shoulders? So you want to be propped up. You want to be careful not to sink. Try to get a little bit of a lift there. Keep your belly button into your back so that your back is supported. Squeeze your bottom. Keep your shoulder blades away from your ears. And with your right heel, kick it twice towards your seat. Now your left heel. Kick, kick. And again, kick, kick. And let's switch. Kick, kick. Just two more sets. Kick, kick one. Kick, kick two. Last time. Kick, kick. And very last one. Kick, kick. Now with your hands, press into the floor and sit back on your heels. Some people call this a child's pose. And then roll up one vertebra at a time. That stretches out your back. And again, I can't stress enough that if for any reason you should not be lying on your stomach, please don't do that exercise. Now we're going to go on to the side lying legs. Now we're going to use the band for this as well. So it doesn't matter which side you start on because we'll do both. So line your back up against your mat or towel, whatever you're using. Take your band, wrap it around the arch of what would be that top foot. For me, this is my left, but it doesn't matter. Now, I like to prop up my head in my hand. But if you do that, just be careful you're not sinking into your neck. Keep your neck supported. Or it's perfectly fine to just rest your head on your arm. Either way works, whatever feels most comfortable for you. Now, you want to stack your hips. Get a little tension there on the band, and by stacking your hips, it'll look like your legs are the same length. Otherwise, if the top hip is back more, it'll look like that top leg is too short, is shorter than the bottom leg. So keep the legs stacked, the shoulders down. Now take a deep breath in, lift your leg, and pull it down. And another one, inhale, lift, exhale to bring it down. Inhale, lift three, exhale, bring it down. Inhale, four, exhale, bring it down, up five, exhale down. Let's do some circles, little circles. One, circle two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Eight circles, reverse eight times. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Now, keep your leg the height of your hip bone, kick it to the front, and then kick it to the back. And again, kick it to the front and to the back. Now, when you do this, make sure that your torso is very stable, that you're not rocking back and forth. If you're not kicking real far, that's okay. The important thing is not how far you can kick. It's keeping your torso stable using your abdominal muscles. That last one, this may be more than five. And then bring them together. Now, let's add another exercise to this. Squeeze your legs together and then lift them a couple inches and hold one, hold two, three, and bring them down. And we'll lift them again and hold two, two, three, and bring them down. Lift and hold three, two, three, bring them down. Two more times. Lift and hold four, two, three, bring them down. One final time. Five, two, three, and bring them down. Okay, now take the band, put it around the bottom foot, the arch of the bottom foot. Now, you can take that top leg, and looks kind of funny, doesn't it? And either lay the knee over top, or if you can, you can stand that foot up. I prefer this myself. I think it's the most comfortable. Grab onto that band so you have a little tension. We're going to do the inner thigh of the bottom leg now. So, put pressure on that band, and then lift that bottom leg up. And here, by the way, lie down on that bottom arm at this point if you're not already. If that isn't comfortable, you know, you still can continue with the way you were doing, but I like to lie down on my bottom arm for this one. And up three, and pull down. Up four, and pull down. Last one, when the leg is up for five, pulse up here. One, two, three, four, five. Five circles. One, two, three, four, five. Change direction. One, two, three, four, five, and lower your leg down. So you've got some inner thigh work there too. Okay, now before we go over to the other side, I'm going to show you heel beats. This is done on your stomach as well. Again, if for any reason you shouldn't be lying on your stomach, just omit the heel beats. Otherwise, you turn over in your stomach, layer your hands one on top of the other, rest your forehead on your hands, lift your feet just a little bit, legs turned out, and lightly beat your heels. One, two, three, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then again, sit back on your heels in a child's pose. and then peel up one vertebra at a time. The reason we do that child's pose, whenever you've been lying down on your stomach, you want to stretch out your back afterwards. Okay, turn to the other side. Take your band again, and we're going to do the same thing we did on the first side. So we'll wrap this around the arch of your top foot. In this case, this is my right. Doesn't matter which one, though. Now, you can either lie down on your bottom arm or prop up. Both feet are to the front, top shoulders down. Remember, those hips are stacked, so it looks like the top leg is as long as the bottom leg. And then we're ready to lift. So inhale, lift. Exhale, lower. Now, try to keep the hips still. You're just lifting the leg and lowering the leg. Try to picture as you're lowering the leg down that you're stretching it across the room. Two more times. Up and down and lift up and down. Let's do 8 circles because I think that's what we did on the other side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Reverse. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now keep the leg lifted the height of your hip and kick it to the front and kick it to the back. Now I find this exercise, the front back's easier to do with the band because you've got resistance. You've got something to press against. Kick front and back. And again, does not matter how far you kick, you want to make sure you keep that torso stabilized and use your abs. And I think this would be the last one. Bring the legs together, squeeze them together, lift them both a couple inches and hold them for 1, 2, 3, and bring them down. Lift and hold 2, 2, 3, and bring it down. Lift and hold 3, 2, 3, and down. 2 more times. Lift and hold 4, 2, 3, and down. 1 more time. Lift and hold 5, 2, 3, and lower down. Okay, now take that band, put it around the arch of the bottom foot, stand the foot up. You can stretch out on that bottom arm, or you can continue to hold on the way you were. Now, you can bring that leg back, that back leg, that bottom leg back a little bit so you're more in a direct line. Flex your foot, keep that top shoulder down, and lift the leg up, pull it down 1. Lift it up, pull it down 2. Lift it up 3, and pull it down. Lift up 4. Pull it down 1 more time. Lift it up 5, hold it up, and pulse 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Keep it up in circle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Reverse. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and lower the leg down. Okay, now take the band and then hug your knees into your chest. That just gives you a little stretch while you take a deep breath. Let's do another one. Inhale and exhale. Okay, now come on up to sitting. Shake out your legs after doing the leg series. Now, we're going to do the mermaid here. So let's sit with the legs crossed in a, like a pretzel. That's one way to do it. Let's do it that way for tonight. Sit up nice and tall. Put your hands beside you. Lift your right arm up. Inhale up. Side bend over. Slide that other arm out. Then inhale, lift up, and exhale, bring it down. Now the other arm, left arm. Doesn't really matter which one you start with, over and up and bring it down. Inhale, lift. Now when you lean over, you can even bend that elbow for more of a stretch. It gives you a little more of an additional stretch and bring it down. Inhale, lift up. Keep the shoulders down, over and lift up and back. Last set. Inhale, reach to the ceiling, stretch out, over, inhale up, exhale down. One more time. Inhale, exhale, over and lift up and back. Now I'm just going to quick show you a variation of this mermaid. You could sit on one hip, like I'm sitting on my right hip and I have my legs crossed to the left, and I'm just going to show you how this will give you a little bit different stretch. I would take my left hand, put it on my left ankle, lift the right arm up. It's a little bit deeper of a stretch, and then lift and down. And left arm up, and you could slide out a little bit more and inhale up and exhale down. Let's do that again. Lift the right arm up, over, getting quite a side stretch tonight. Inhale up, slide out, and lift and back. And the way to do the other side, You just lift your legs, swing them around to the other side, and you're in the same position on the other side. So now I put my right hand on my right ankle, and I start with my left arm. I lift up, over. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, down. Stretch up, over, and up, and down. One more so we're even. Can't be uneven. And over, and lift up. Bring it down. Last time, inhale up. You can slide out farther, but try to keep that opposite hip down. Lift up and down. Okay, so again, we'll shake out the legs. Now I'm going to show you an exercise called the seal. We'll just do a couple reps. You lift your seat to your heels. Lift your feet just like with rolling like a ball, but open your knees in that space in there. Take your hands, thread them through, and grab your ankles. Now you bring your chin to your chest, and you clap your feet. One, two, three. Now roll back, and here if you can. One, two, three. And then we'll come up. Clap, clap, clap. And we'll go back. Let's just do one more time. One, two, three. And back, two, three. And then we'll come on up. Now, if that doesn't feel comfortable, you don't have to do that. You could always even just do the claps, roll back, and not do the claps. You know, just do them at the beginning like this. One, two, three. And then just go back sort of like for rolling like a ball, and then come up and do your claps again. But as always, whenever you're rolling, keep your chin tucked. Now, I was looking at the camera, but keep your chin down. You don't want to go onto your neck, just as far as your shoulder blades. So that's a little bit of work with the band tonight, and I'm so glad that you joined me this evening. Again, if you have any questions on Pilates, give this call at 378-0426. Until next time, good night.